Maybe I should equip another power one. I'll just be hitting bombs left and right. Alright, let's give it a shot. See what happens. 6-7 on the season. I'm ice cold. 236 average. Oh my. We gotta figure it out.
We are under the lights here on a Friday night at Oracle Park in San Francisco. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series.
Alright. So since last episode and now, I've got the gold archetype. So that has increased some of my stats. Let's see what it shows in my... Oh, it doesn't. We'll see what that does. I upped my... So now I get a third, like, what are the small ones called, I guess? I don't know. Was it base hit? Look at that vision. 101 vision, 103 contact, 97 power. Okay. So now I have three of those, I don't know what you call them, the things underneath the archetype. So I have power, I don't even know which power. Oh, he's got a slow release. Get there. Nice. So I've got a power equipped, I've got two contacts equipped, which, so we'll see what this does. I'm going to use it for a couple games, see what happens. Otherwise I could double up on power, or I could put speed. I've thought about putting speed, but for what I want to do, or for my player type, you're supposed to be power. But I kind of wanted to get more plate vision because I seem to be terrible at that. So close.
Baseman Jared Cannon. Now here it comes. Round to third. Reined in. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. Next to the plate for the Padres, Jared Cannon grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result that's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
McMahon is there, one away. So here is Jared Cannon, a potential tying run for him at third base. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Yastrzemski is there to make the catch, and they'll escape the bases. Three to two, the finish in tonight's game. The Giants took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Tanner Tully gets the win on the
I should have looked. Are my stats still capped at 50? For everything? For like power and contact?
We're counting you down to baseball this afternoon on the MLB pregame show, and as we draw close to a truly gorgeous afternoon for baseball. Shohei Ohtani is on the mound for game two. What's your take on him, Dan? So now here is Jared Cannon looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. First offering on its way.
No, I was not prepared to swing at that. It was actually in there. How do I have like a 10 game hitting streak? I must be getting one hit per game, and that's it, because I'm hitting 237. Oh, why did I swing at that?
striding in is Jared Cannon, 0-for-1 here in the early going. First pitch of the AB on its way. Now he extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. And
oh my God!
Straight away right. Will he try from second? Start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, let's see if he can work a walk, maybe a knock, ground ball with eyes, something. Catch a gap to get this offense going. Two hits as a team can start demoralizing your confidence. But if he can get on, start some traffic in motion, we might have something.
A ball and a strike to the Padres' first baseman. Back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
The 3-1. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth. So a runner at first now with nobody out. And standing in now, the always dangerous third baseman, Manny Machado. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Cannon aboard here at first with nobody out. Grounded to third. This could be two. Fielded cleanly. Odor back to first, and Machado's retired as well. It's a double play.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the two ball.
Now to bat, Jared Cannon. Fourth trip to the plate for him, and he's at risk of ending that nice hitting streak that he's put together.
Yeah, you don't want to be selfish, Matty. You never want to be that in a team sport, but right here, he's well aware of his hit streak on the line.
Ah, terrible. Popped it up.
Slater's under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. To score this afternoon. The Giants led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Shohei Ohtani earns the win, his second, as he racked up 10 strikeouts in the effort. Sunday afternoon baseball on the show as we welcome you inside Oracle Park in San Francisco. Get ready for Giants baseball. So next to hit is Jared Cannon. First chance for him here in the top of the first. Nobody on. Danny Dero, this Giants team, as they begin play here this afternoon. They come in winners of two straight, and they've been playing some good baseball as well.
Yeah, Matty, without question. They find themselves in this position today. They got a chance to sweep the series on Sunday and make it a miraculous weekend.
Boy, Dero, it's always a nice way to finish off a weekend. You win a big game on Saturday, and to close it off with a win here.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. Padres nothing, Giants coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. At the plate now is Jared Cannon. Flew out last time up.
Sharp oh my
ball
God.
To third. He's got it. Throw on to first, two gone.
Now at the plate, Jared Cannon. He bounced out last time up, and he's back standing. And another throw over. And a dive, but he's back in there. Here's the first pitch to him.
With that base running threat on first base, man, does that change the pitcher's whole mentality. This guy at the plate should assume nothing but heaters coming right at him.
A ball and a strike to the Padres' first baseman. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. Out in front as he grounds this one to short. Right to him. Little pitch and catch chance for Odor at second base, and that'll do it. So it's no runs on no hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Top of the order due up in the home half of the... So now to the plate, Jared Cannon. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball.
Wow, the Padres have been scuffling so far. They need to get a big hit, and it's about time somebody comes through right about now.
Missed low and inside with it, 1-1. Polanco on second. Grisham is over at first with one away. Hit hard towards second. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
Oh, we're going three. Easy.
And the runner will score from second.
That's in that deep corner there.
Hey, D-Roll, that's a big RBI right there to stretch this lead to three. Takes a lot of pressure off your pitcher going into the bottom part of the inning.
Yeah, Dan, no doubt. As an offense, all you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that three-run cushion has to make you feel good.
O'Neill has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. So a runner at third, two men are out, and that'll bring in Manny Machado. Pulled high in the air out to left field. O'Neill waits on it. And that ends the inning. Three to one, the final score this It's time now for baseball from the great state of Texas in Globe Life Field. Tonight, the first of this quick two-game series between the...
Cannon.
Now at the plate is Jared Cannon. First offering. And fellas, you take a look at this Rangers team entering play here tonight. They come in scuffling a bit of late, just 2-4 over their last six games.
Yeah, Matty, these players got in their cars today to drive to the stadium focused on one thing. Not who was going to be the hero, just the fact that they needed a W and that one of their teammates, whether it's them or someone else, has to come up with
it. I'm not seeing the ball at all right now. This is crazy. I didn't even hit it there. I can't see it.
Now to the plate, Jared Cannon. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep in the last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's...
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side.
So two runs on one hit, and the one hit was a big one, the home run. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. The Padres lead it 2-0. Into the box, Jared Cannon. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Fouled off. The 1-2. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Digging in next, Jared Cannon struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Here comes the 1-0. Grounded back up the middle. Speared on the dive. The throw to first. Not in time. Nearly a highlight reel play, but they'll have a runner on here with one away. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Fernando Tatis Jr. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And he is out on the tag.
Decisions like that have to be made knowing who you've got at the plate. This guy can put one over the fence. Nope.
A 4-1 finish in this evening's game. The Padres led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Zach Gallen takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over. Now from the home of the Rangers, we're at Globe Life Field in Arlington. Today, the finale of this quick two-game series between the San Diego Padres and the Texas Rangers.
And now, your 2025 Texas Cannon.
Next, it'll be Jared Cannon. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Way late on the fastball for strike one. Fellas, this Rangers ball club, as they begin play, they come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped 5 of their last 8 ball games.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Row, talk about a team that's scuffling right now. I had a chance to talk to the manager before the game. He's not happy. The players aren't happy.
Yeah, and just a malaise has kind of come over this clubhouse. We had a chance, like you said, to walk through it a little bit. The boys are not jumping around. This
well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. Padres down. Stepping up is Jared Cannon, grounded out in his last at-bat. Hit hard towards center. That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now.
We take a look at the numbers up to this point. You see he's only given up 2 hits so far today, so he's been hitting his spots all game long. Remains to be seen if he can keep that shutout intact going forward, but I'm not betting against him.
He pops him up toward the left side of the infield. Delgado takes charge, and he's got it. 2 down. And in steps Manny Machado. No runs, 2 hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Calhoun waits on it. And that retires the side. So no runs on a hit here, no errors.
Three,
Half of the sixth about to get started, and here comes the first baseman, Jared Cannon.
If you look at their win percentage or something like that right now, gotta be honest, the odds are obviously stacked against them. But I'm looking for them to show me something right here. Maybe they get back in this game, maybe they don't. But I want to see what kind of at-bats they put together. This is where you have to lock in as a team. Every guy has to go up to the plate and have a good, productive AB to get this team going.
And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Now into the box, Jared Cannon. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
A ball and a strike to the Padres' first baseman.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Hit the other way out toward right field. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends. Now at the plate here is Jared Cannon. Flew out last time up. He's ready. Now the pitch. Hit in the air out to straightaway left field. Calhoun waits on it. And that ends the inning. And this afternoon's closes at a runs. Downtown San Diego and Petco Park on a third. Denelson Lamet will be on the mound for the series opener. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really been struggling lately. In his last three starts, he has a whip of over 1.50. Lots of base runners, lots of hits, and lots of walks, and that doesn't add up to very good performances.
Next, it'll be Jared Cannon. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. Guys, you take a look at the Giants as they begin play here tonight. They come in the midst of a stretch where they've dropped six of their last nine.
All right, Matty, they show up for game one of this road trip. They have to find a way to play a little bit better baseball. Coming off a recent homestand where they were only able to squeak out three wins, but at the end of the day, the way this team's been playing, three wins is a significant positive. So let's see how game one of this road trip treats them.
0-2, here it comes. And he fouls this one off. Here comes another 0-2. In the dirt here. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And that'll move the runner up to second as it takes away the double play possibility.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with. But there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up free bases.
Here comes the 1-2. Fly ball into straightaway left. Yastrzemski is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. So now into the box is Jared Cannon, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Now the first pitch. And it's fouled away. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a miss. That one tied him up.
I think getting the leadoff man in every inning is important as a pitcher. When you're coming off an inning that you really labored through, it makes all the difference mentally.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And there's the first out. Now it'll be Jared Cannon. No hits and two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Prior to the at-bat, a check on first, and the runner back easily. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes. What are you supposed to do other than keep trying new guys until someone starts attacking the zone?
Center fielder on the run. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Ready now is Jared Cannon. He'll have the opportunity to kick things off as we begin the home sixth. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
That was a good swing right there. Might be the best one he's had all night because he was right on it.
Hit on the ground out to short. Scooped up. And quickly there's one down to lead off the frame. Thank you.
So the next to bat will be Jared Cannon. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
First offering gets ahead of him here as he got him to swing over the top of this one.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now, he's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
Hit hard towards center, and that'll get down for a base hit. Long throw to third, and he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away. So here's the cleanup hitter, Fernando Tatis Jr., grounded out in his last at-bat. Here's the 0-1 pitch, grounded to first. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score.
Hey, Dero, that's a big RBI right there to stretch this lead to three. Takes a lot of pressure off your pitcher going into the bottom part of the inning.
Yeah, Dan, no doubt. As an offense, all you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that three-run cushion has to make you feel good.
Here's Manny Machado now. Three hits in three trips to the plate for him so far. Machado now on 0-1. Sliced hard on the ground, and that's through for a base hit. He'll come home with it. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Hey, that's what you try and do as an offense. You get a four-run lead. They're a grand slam ahead, Dan, but you're a former closer warming up. When you see a three-run lead, and then your offense gets it to four, and you know that save situation's gone out the window.
Next to stand in is Jared Cannon, singled in his last at bat. Righty against righty as this is taken for a ball. It's 1-0.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
Dubon calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out. Seven, the final score in this ball game. San Diego rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Kyle Muller gets the win in relief, his second of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us. The weekend is on deck, and so is nighttime baseball from Petco Park in San Diego's Stepping up to the plate, Mauricio Dubon. And he's a guy who's been absolutely terrific over the last couple of series.